everyone. Welcome to our Hyperloop workshop here in Delft. This is where for the past year we've been working on what we like to think as the future of transportation, the Hyperloop. This course will take you through the basics of the Hyperloop every week. However, first we will start with the most basic concept of the Hyperloop, very high speed at very high efficiency. Let's first start with finding the issues in current day transportation that we need to change. First, we have congestion. Just think of the long lines at the check-in at the airport during your last holiday. Secondly, transportation is heavily polluting our environment by producing greenhouse gases. And lastly, our transportation systems are often very prone to external influences. Every winter, many trains and planes are delayed or even cancelled due to them being incompatible with heavy snowfall. And even worse, external influences like fog during heavy traffic lead to an increased risk of accidents. If we then also look at our most basic needs in transportation, to get from A to B fast and by emitting little polluting gases, we can rank all of our transport systems in this graph. We see that our fastest system, the airplane, is quite fast, but not very efficient. Switching to trains, which can still be quite fast, we already see an improvement in its efficiency characteristics. Even slower, the car is also more polluting. And we see that more efficient is either walking or cycling, but both are incredibly slow and not useful for long distances. One concerning observation is that we do not have a transportation system that's both very fast and very efficient. This is where we think the Hyperloop forms a solution.
Being both very fast and efficient, this is what makes Hyperloop fill the gap which is currently seen. The Hyperloop vehicle, or pods as we like to call them, will transfer the passengers in a vacuum tunnel. The pods will be both designed for passenger comfort as well as safety. For levitation, we could use wheels.
Or we could use passive magnets or any other alternative for levitation. Next, we can look into our braking and see whether we include it into our pod itself
or if the brakes mounted on a separate vehicle, which we'd like to call the launcher. This makes the Hyperloop pod a modular vehicle, kind of like with a train and a locomotive, in where the locomotive also houses the propulsion.
Or we could think of having an external propulsion force in the form of a linear induction motor.
As you can see, there's many different building blocks from which you can create a Hyperloop vehicle. By picking the right elements, we can create a new transport solution that's not only faster than all of the others, but also more efficient.
Next to vehicle design, Hyperloop also requires new infrastructure. This here is Europa's first Hyperloop tube, here on the TU Delft campus. Once Hyperloop will be operational, the Hyperloop tubes will be the largest vacuum chambers in the world.
The network we will be able to build for Hyperloop will be like a metro system connecting the major cities on entire continents with travel times under an hour. Hyperloop stations would function as major hubs connecting surrounding cities with the Hyperloop network. This will mean that I will be able to live here in Delft and be able to study in Paris without an increase in traffic time.
We think Hyperloop is a true game changer for the transport sector, and we see that it's on the brink of happening.
Therefore, we're very happy to see that you've joined us for this course and look forward to the progress we'll all make over the next coming weeks.